Absolutely.
Just like the Marlin way, we getting it all. Marlin adjusts his shoe.
Yes.
Yeah, so it's fixed now. It's not the shoe, it's the sock. My sock keep him down. All right, cool.
All right, it's Morning Mixtape with Mike Love, and we are here with Marlon Wayans.
That's me.
He's got a brand new show that starts this Wednesday on NBC. Marlon.
Sure do.
Marlon.
I'm gonna be somebody.
8 o'clock. What is that? Oh.
It's my first.
It did. It was like, I was like,
someone farted in the bowl.
No, I mean, I'm all for broccoli, though. I mean, I'm vegan, so all I eat is vegetables.
Yeah, I just recently tried to go vegan. I would say I'm 93% vegan.
Really?
I went to steak something 42, something I have right here, and I just had to have some steak.
Wow. And it just effed up your whole inside.
Not at all. It made me dance on the inside.
What was the last time you ate meat before then?
About a month and a half ago.
Really? And it didn't run right through you? Just all that meat that was left over in your
car. I didn't have a big 32-ounce steak.
Okay.
I had 3 ounces of Wagyu.
I don't know that.
That's why you quit meat.
Wagyu?
They massage it. Send it to the spa, then they kill it.
right.
They don't kill it like violently.
Okay.
Wagyu steak, they take.
They kind of slide up.
You know, put a little.
Like in jail.
Put a little cloth on there. They gently hack it up. When did you turn vegan? You watch What the Health?
No. I watched Forks Over Knives about 4 years ago.
I haven't watched it.
Forks Over Knives. What the Hell. Yeah, that's like on social media real big right now. So there's a lot of people that are like jumping in that direction. But
have you lost weight? Have you noticed
improvement, sleep better at night, feel good, I feel healthier.
What do you do to supplement your protein?
Protein, I find, is not as important as we make it as a society. Like, that's a societal thing, protein. Protein is more something they tell us we need, but like just eating that broccoli, like you get probably enough protein for your day.
I don't know. I think, you know.
You're just a skinny dude. And
everybody got fat potential. We all get the brother cheeks. You know, you threw enough of that vodka tequila or in that beer, you get the brother cheeks. I work out a lot. Uh-huh. I work out. I eat a lot of vegetables. I eat a lot of fruit. A lot of vegetables. A little bit of grains.
Okay.
And I try to supplement my protein by having beans and legumes,
that's
things
important.
Like that. But I make sure that I have like a protein shake in the morning,
okay.
And maybe at night, maybe a little fish.
Okay.
But not every day.
The Marlon diet, ladies and gentlemen. So let's talk about the show.
If you want to be 45 and look 25,
yeah, and that's it. That's
then that, do the Marlon diet.
That's for me, the young lady that brought you up. What's her name again, Red? Tamika?
Yeah.
Tamika. So she met me years ago and she said, wow, you look exactly like she met me when I did my old radio show, and that's over 10 years ago.
What I'll do?
I'm 51.
Right, good. 51?
Yeah. So that's.
What are you going to do to improve?
What do you mean?
What are you going to do to improve? Every year you got to get better. What adjustments do you make? Like this year I was like, I'm going to make it a commitment to work out 5 to 6 days a week.
5 to 6. I gotta start working out. I'd say go to church. But that's a lie. I'd be lying.
Food and you ain't.
I don't even see that's
detoxifying your system with working
every now and then on the treadmill. Every now and then I walk.
I have to get in on this. I have to get in on this.
Right,
every morning mixtape, I do a 20-minute workout with the mix. He does like what, 20 seconds?
I lose my breath real quick.
Well, you got to fix that.
Yeah,
I do. Your life right. You got to do an hour every morning.
An hour.
Sweat. 1 hour.
Okay. Treadmill
because
on
because your body is the first half hour. You're really only working out a half hour. Because the first half hour, your body's just like.
Just getting into it.
Yeah. So the next half hour is what's really important. So you got to every five, 6 days a week.
Mm-hmm.
And then you'll notice a difference in your health and your strength, and you'll feel
right.
You'll be like, oh, this is something different. Because if you're doing the work with the eating,
not do the work physically. You can't just do it with, eating. That's a discipline.
That's why I still got a bit of a tire.
Right. So if you want to get rid of the tire, all the grains and things, that'll burn off. Mm-hmm. But you just got to work out.
There it is.
You can't do 20 seconds and be like, I'm winded. You got to fix your life.
Why you got to see? I know you're not the queen of winded. Like, woo,
I go for 20 minutes, though.
You do.
In the studio, in the morning, while we're on the air and the mix is playing.
Two or three days.
Live.
You got to go 5 days a week.
At least work out
5 to 6 days a week.
Indeed.
For an hour.
An hour.
You'll notice the results immediately, especially the way you eat.
Yeah.
You'll notice the results.
So, and I don't drink, so.
In my little food pot.
You ain't got no excuse.
Yeah. I'm just like.
You're supposed to be Diesel.
Yeah. I'm supposed to be wearing fine shirts like you.
Yeah.
Tighter shirts.
Yeah. Yo.
Yeah, right now, you're all wrong.
You eat right for nothing.
Not for nothing. I mean,
you got a boring life for no reason. We're going to have a boring life, at least be Diesel.
At least work out. At least be Diesel.
You just damn boring.
Oh, I live. You know what?
I'm frustrated for you.
I've lived my life already. All that excitement, pre-50, all the stuff I did, all the stuff. I'm a radio guy. I've been in radio for 30 years. So, we lived a life.
Do you want to see 90?
Exactly. And that's why I cut
Get
out
your
all that.
Ass on the treadmill.
On the treadmill.
I'm making excuses. Why not?
I'm not making excuses.
I can tell by the way he said gym. He didn't mean it. He said in the gym. You lift a weight like this.
All right. So, the show Marlon, which airs starting this Wednesday,
yes, sir.
On NBC. Welcome back to Primetime.
Thank you.
Television, obviously, you had the show.
Thank you.
With the Wayans brothers back in the day. But
yes, sir.
First on the Major 4 network. So
first time I got a show on a network that has more than two letters in the acronym. I finally
right. No more EWs.
No more CWs and. Right. And WBs, this is actual. We're doing big things.
Yeah, and you guys are going out. Tell me about now on the show. You have a webcast. I watched the pilot episode.
Yes.
Yeah, as he says, he says 6 million viewers. Puts up seven fingers, but he says
6 million.
How?
Somebody been watching.
I watched.
You got the bootleg.
Shout out to NBC for hooking up the first six episodes.
Oh, you got the first six?
I watched the first six.
Wow.
Yeah. Six episodes. So I'm coming into this prepared.
Wow.
It's OG Radio, where we prepare.
Six episodes.
I've seen six episodes.
Well, I'll tell you what.
Episodes of the show.
If the show was bad, you'd be like, they sent me six episodes.
And, so in the first episode, we find out that Marlon has a webcast. He has 6 million followers. But I don't know what Marlon does and how Marlon got 6 million followers and how Marlon makes his money.
Well, you got to see the prequel.
Damn it!
He's the new millionaire. You know what I mean? The new millionaire is these social media guys who gets money based on their ads, based on different brand sponsorships.
Right.
So based on their views, they get money. And what I wanted to do was, everything's going to the cell phone nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to bring the cell phone to the networks.
Okay.
I want to involve these kids that we're losing the audience, TV audiences, we're losing to the phone. So I wanted to bring the phone as a part of the actual show.
Right.
Because this way you're bringing those little phone heads back to the network. And it's the new millionaire. So I could have went comedian, but I wanted to do something where I could still have my voice. And I thought social media was a good way to go.
Right. And the dope thing about it is he starts out every show with, the webcast. The first shot is, Marlon on the screen of the phone. So you're a millionaire from doing this?
I mean, he does well. Man.
Because he's got a nice place.
I won't say numbers, but
he
has a nice place. And he has his kids got a nice place, but she got a job and she's working. But, when you got two different places and you got kids in private school, it's a well-off family, it's a different kind. Cosby did well, but he was a doctor.
Right, and his wife was a lawyer.
Right. This is a different kind of upwardly mobile family.
Okay, 2017.
2017. So it's not, a doctor, a lawyer.
Right.
They do well. Still doing well. She's an interior decorator. And he's a social media star.
Yeah, and so Essence Atkins plays your wife on the show.
Who's awesome in the show.
Yeah, yeah. And, of course, we know them together from Haunted House. Yeah. They did that together. Was she your first choice as your wife, or did she beat out, you know, a million other actors?
There was other actresses that came in that was actually really good. Mm-hmm. But there's just something about the way she works with me that works well. Mm-hmm. I think she listens well. I'm all over the place. I don't dialogue wise, I hear what we wrote.
Right.
When I'm in the moment, I just some things you just can't script. Right. When I go on my runs, you gotta be able to go
with the ride.
Flow.
Right.
She flows with me. She knows when to bounce in. How to stay in the scene. She never breaks.
She looks like she does.
Now, Brisha, terrible. Brisha will be like,
Yeah, I could tell because if you watch closely, and I watched six episodes, I could see where there were places where they had to edit, or just people with like little smiles on their face.
Brisha kept breaking. But, you know, because she don't know what I'm going to do from time to time.
The funniest scene in all of the episodes that I saw was when Marlon, they were doing an intervention. And you redid the father doing the cry.
Yeah.
And he did it exactly like the father. And I died. Like I was rolling watching the show. So
it was great. It's like every episode we try to put something in there that you go, oh, that's funny. Like I want people to laugh out loud. And I want it to be good. Before when I was younger, it was about good. And the reason why I let go of parody, I stopped doing parody because I couldn't do story. Mm-hmm. Or good enough story. And I couldn't act. I couldn't hold things down in the kind of emotionally grounded way that I wanted to. So I wanted to spread my wings and have a show that is good, but it's really funny.
Right.
And the fact that this show is about a relationship and about a family. You know, that's at the forefront, the frontal lobe of what the show is. And then there's a whole lot of funny stuff. And everything funny he does is based through